Hello everyone, welcome to the session of English grammar course for class 6. This is part 2 of the topic description writing. So in the previous session we saw one type of description writing, that was the description of a person. In this session we will talk about description of a place or a scene. Okay, so let's start. So let's start with the description of a place. First we'll see the important points that we have to keep in mind. First one is name of the place. Obviously the place you have to mention, place or scene, okay, what you are describing. Then location, where it is located. Then dimension, shape, stories, etc. So dimension, shape, stories, you do not need to go in all details, exactly how much kilometers or meters or whatever, okay, square feet or not that detailed description. You can just describe that it is a big or huge place or something like that. Okay, then what kind of atmosphere is there in that place. Now type, whether it is a building, a park or a monument. Okay, this is mostly applicable to a place. For a scene, for example, let's say you went to a vegetable market. So exactly what you saw. So you can mention that where this vegetable market is located. Okay, and then whether it is too big or a small market. Okay, then what kind of atmosphere is there. These kind of thing. Then sights and sounds, means what you saw over there. In the place also you can describe what kind of things you saw nearby or something like that. And sounds, then purpose or use, what is the use or purpose of that place or the scene which you are seeing. For example, the vegetable market, what is the use of that. Then for place you can write history, who built it and when. Then importance of that place and ending up. Okay, so without making any delay, what we'll do is that we'll go through one example which you have to note down in your copies, okay, and I'll go through it and then we'll discuss it step by step. So let's start over here. So I have decided to discuss a scene over here. Give a detailed description of a scene of a railway station you recently visited. So now this is a place, it is a railway station, it is a place. But you have to describe the scene, what you saw over there in the railway station. Okay, so how did I start? Yesterday I visited to the city railway station to receive my uncle. Okay, it is located to the north of the Civil Lines Market, the busiest market of the city. So you can use imaginary locations as well. It is not necessary to use every time to use the correct pinpoint location only from your city only, whatever you know. So you can use any kind of location. So first what we did, we mentioned that we went to the city railway station and then its location. Okay, the city station is a big and noisy place. It has 8 platforms where trains continuously come and go in one or the other direction. Okay, so in this way what we have done, we are describing the dimensions or shape which we have mentioned in the points, that it is a you can say it is average, your average railway station, not too small, not too big. Okay, it has 8 platforms and many trains come and go. Now you'll start your description, what you saw over there. So what a noise there was on the platform. People were shouting, engines were whistling, carriages were being shunted and trains were coming in and going out. So this is a regular scene on a platform. If you have ever traveled somewhere by train, you might have noticed this. All over the place people are shouting, the engines, the whistle, you hear the whistle of the engine. So you describe the sights and sounds of the scene over there. Okay, the platform was crowded with hundreds of passengers who seemed to be anxiously waiting for the train. So some of the other train might be coming or going, so these people are waiting over there. This is a very common scene which you see in a station. The station was a huge place. It looked like a fort. There was a big waiting hall for third class passengers. It was fitted with benches and electric fans. There were stalls. There were ticket offices, booking offices, refreshment rooms and bookstalls. So we are describing the entire scene what we saw over there. There was a long bridge spanning all the 8 railway lines. On every platform there were crowds of people waiting for the train, and porters were carrying passengers' luggage on their heads or wheeling luggage barrows. Okay, so luggage barrows are those trolleys you might have seen, small trolley like carrier with the wheels which the people pull over there, keeping their luggage on that. Okay, It seemed a very big place, and yet father told me it was nothing as compared to the stations of Delhi, Kolkata, Mumbai and Chennai. So in this way we have ended by making a conclusion that although it's to me it seemed that it was so huge, but my father told me that it was nothing in comparison to the other railway stations, these big railway stations of the metro cities. Okay, so in this way we have ended our description of a scene of a place. Okay, so one more time I'll go through it, and I'll just pause I'll just zoom in my camera on that. You can note it down or you can pause it so that everything is visible to you and you can note it down it properly in your notebooks. I hope everything is visible to you now. You can pause the video and note it down in your notebooks. Okay? Now, this is a practice question for you people. Hints are given. Okay, so this is a description of a place. You recently visited Red Fort. Write a detailed description of the Red Fort. Besides other things, you should include where it is located, how big it is, shape, color and design, material used to make it, why it was it built, history, who built it, when was it built, etc. Its importance till this date. Okay, so you can use the hints here. Although it is a very famous historical monument, so you can take help also. But I will appreciate if you people write it on your own using these hints. Obviously, for other details, for example, location and all that, you will be needing some help from the, you can take help from net and all. But try to write this on your in your own words. Just collect the data. Okay. So this is it for today. In the next session, we will discuss the third type of description writing, that is description of an event. Okay, so for a few seconds I'll again stop my camera over this question so that you can see it properly. So this is it for today. I'll see you in the next session. Till then, goodbye and take care of yourself.